מסגד נבי רובין, המסגד שהיה על נחל רובין, בפלמחים, בנחל סורק, מה שנקרא. שם, מקור השם נחל סורק הוא מהמילה שורקה, סוג של גפן שמצוין בשמואל ב', והנחל שימש כדרך מעבר מחוף הים לכיוון בית שמש, ואחר כך גם נוצל לכיוון ירושלים. והתושבים חיו מסביבו, והיו שיירות שהיו מתנהלות לאורך הנחל בגלל המים. עכשיו אנחנו בסקירה כללית, טיול של רפי, ובליווי של הצלם ועריכה של קובי גוטל. רפי מאירי, מורה בפלמחים, מורה ללימודי הטבע. אנחנו חוצים את הנחל, שהוא נחל איתן. בחורף יש בו הרבה יותר מים, ומלווה אותו צמחייה של נחלים, ואנחנו מתארים ככה את צמחיית הפטל והצמחים מלווי נחל, כמו טיון דביק, ועוד צמחים שצמודים ועצי דקל מסביב לנחל, אותם אני מחזיק רגע ביד. This is Sorek River. The name Sorek, it's from the Shoraka. It's in the Bible from Shmuel Bet, second. And we are going to the area of the mask of Nebi Rubin. Rubin was one of the important people during the Bible time. Reuven. So this is the name they gave him to the area. And here I am, the teacher, Rafi Meiri. I'm explaining about the plain and the environment around the Nachal, and now about the river, Nachal in Hebrew. We're going to travel and to go to the mosque close to the river, where was a village during the Bible time. After that, they left, the people left, and during the Turkish and before, some people came during, since 1043-42 was a settlement there, and there is a big place they bury the end of the Gaza area, because they didn't want to bury him in Gaza, not to cause problem to the government they replace him. So they put him out of Gaza and they bury him here by the river. And I'm dressing as a typical people, how they used to dress in this time. As you can see, the keffiyeh around my neck. And now we're going to pass through the plant. It's a area, it's with a lot of sand, because the sand came from the river. Wasn't any plant around to stop from the wind to bring all the sand from the beach and from the area of Egypt. So it's a long time ago, a lot of sand came during the Nile from the stone we call granite, was destroyed by the wind and the environment. This area around that we're walking, and in the place that I'm going to now to show you was they dig to find water. And you know, if you're digging about 20 meters down, you can find some water or sign of water. And here was a place they in the old time, like let's say 70, 60 years ago, still was around, was all that you can get water from the sand if you dig down about 20 meter, maybe a little bit lower, you know. And here the stones that surround the area of the water are all. When I'm walking, you can see some sign because the people traveling, people coming here to the area. It's like important area in Israel for traveling and to the four-wheel truck, and was big settlement there. And here is the wall of the mosque. It was in a past, yeah. And the mosque just turned down, was turned, and because of the weather, didn't succeed to like to still be there and collapse. And you see this area the surround, and was a Turkish army used to live there, and also to protect the area from the place, and the people can come to steal the all of the merchandise from the people. They was moving it from the sea to Bechemesh and to the other area. So after the independent war, the people they used to live there just ran away and left this area to nobody, and nobody is living there, nobody take care about it, and just nice place to look at to see how it's look like today. And this is, by the way, the color, it's because in some culture, this color represent the protect from ghosts and other stories, other, like we said, how the people believe. So they put like a color of turquoise, and you see this is a sign how people used to live here. This is all where was a tower of the mosque, and here was a place the guy who was calling people to pray used to be. And we are going out of the place now, and the face for this place is to Mecca. It's important place to the Muslim. So we finished the tour and to travel around this place called Nebi Rubin or Sorek River. This was what exists from the tower, and from the, you see the sign on the wall. And in the side of this building, you can see new stones, because I told you there was buried the head of Gaza. His name was Humrah. They didn't want to bury him, they didn't want to cause fight to the religion, to the people they believe in him, to tell the new government they came after him. And this is grave. It's out of the fence. It's outside, but matched to the wall. As you can see it, yeah. And it's also painted in blue.